You're watching View from the Top, and I'm in conversation with Chief Executive and Managing Director of Religare, Sunil Godhwani. Sunil, let's talk about the focus areas going forward. You said whatever looks good and whatever fits into your portfolio. Right now, what are you mapping out?
On the financial side, let's speak on the financial side of the business. That's the mothership. I think clearly we are into all business today except general insurance and forex. These are two areas we haven't touched.
Mm-hmm.
We are scouting around to expand our health insurance at this point, and that's pretty much online. That's the new thing that we started. We have got a team into place. Hopefully we'll launch product with the IRD approvals in the next 5 to 6 months, and then after general insurance. The natural evolvement has to be that you have to have all the financial services integrate into a major sort of institution, and that integration is a process that's going to happen only with time.
Organic, inorganic, in the both areas that you've spoken about.
I'm stressing on both. I mean, any opportunity presents itself, we'll go for it.
Some
There's
names
no issue.
Which come into your mind on health insurance?
We're hunting. Put it that way. We are consistently hunting for them.
All right, I can't get that name or those names out. You know, when we talk about the cash, you know, sitting on a huge pile of cash, the family is. Yet, if you look at the acquisitions you've done, you've leveraged a lot. It's not as if you're using all of your cash. Going forward, how would we see the businesses?
I don't know what you call a huge pile of cash. No cash is ever a huge pile. Let's be clear. Any cash can be, we can deplete any pile of cash. There's no
Absolutely,
debate on
but you're not depleting it. That's the interesting part of it.
No, idea is to use the cash in a meaningful manner.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, today we have we are in a fortunate position, I think, from a timing perspective, to sit with very liquid, you know, the liquidity available within the system. Mm-hmm. It's our challenge, and it's also the mindset to utilize the liquidity in a more meaningful manner. What really takes us further with that liquidity? And that's the challenge we are constantly facing. That is, in fact, you know, we never like to think that we have liquidity. We always approach every opportunity thinking, okay, how are we going to meaningfully deploy the funds that gives us the maximum bandwidth, the maximum reach, or whatever we are willing to do?
Mm-hmm.
So there is the issue always that we will go for leveraging, putting in capital, and we leverage. I mean, capital is the most important thing. So you like to use the capital in a very sensible manner. On a specific basis, I don't think we are leveraging Religare at all, you know, but we are open to leveraging, because today, if you do not leverage, you will lose all opportunities. You will have to leverage. The question is, do you leverage in the right manner?
Mm-hmm.
Do you leverage for the right product? And then you deliver to the shareholder the right value for the leveraging.
Mm-hmm.
And I think in all three categories, I would say, very comfortable with delivering in all three commitments.
All right, speaking about funding for the businesses, would you be looking at taking any of your financial services businesses to the markets?
Well, right now the holding company is publicly listed.
Any of the subsidiaries?
They
must
be open to that. But I think the timing is critical. It needs to mature. Today, all businesses are handled by capable CEOs there. There are chief executives running the businesses. They are very independent. They are empowered. They have built up enough bandwidth. They've got a whole team of people they're managing. I think with the right timing and the right size, yes, we'll be open to that.
Mm-hmm. Any thoughts on which would these businesses be and how soon could that be? Because think about it, Sunil. I mean, holding, traditionally at least, holding company structures, the value discovery of holding companies is just never there in the markets or at the stock market.
It's a perspective. When we went public, we were one of the first companies to go the holding company model. And I think the market has rewarded us well, and the shareholders have got, they've never lost out on us. It's very difficult to pinpoint which business eventually will go, because I think the financial paradigm, the way the financial markets are today, mm-hmm. and the way the businesses are going to be down the line, it's going to be significantly different than historically what has happened. So we need to have an open mind to that. Maybe the idea of taking subsidiaries listed may not be the best idea in the near future. Maybe down the line it may be.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we need to move away from the historically what has happened or the historical data. We need to keep an open mind what's lying in future and plan accordingly. So I would not like to pinpoint a business, but I think we will have significant amount of businesses ready. Yes, you are right. In the holding company structure, sometimes the true valuation does not get captured. But that's a function of how we communicate our businesses. I think we communicate pretty well. If we translate and what we are doing into the right communication and focus into the investors, we should be able to get the valuation. I don't think that will be a challenge.
All right. Well, your recent attempts at strengthening your global investment banking business, you've appointed a new CEO. Now, look at the banking scenario in India. For large groups like yours who've got a 360 presence in financial services, banking would be the next step, but regulations just don't allow you to do that. Is that something you would lobby hard for?
Well, banking, becoming a bank would be a natural progress. It will be a natural evolution that has to happen. I don't know when it will happen. Lobbying for it, will it help? Will it not help? I don't think so. I think we are in the business of running our own businesses. Whenever the regulation or the opportunity presents itself, we'll grab it. We don't have a debate on that. Whether it happens under the Religare, whether it happens in the partnership with somebody, that's a function of time, how we evolve, what the situation is. You know, that's something we can't really pinpoint again today. However, yes, the opportunity is there. It is ultimately to get a client 360 degrees, you need to be a bank, because then his money lies with you. You get access to the cheap CASA, to the lower, you know, the rates.
Yeah.
And that is fundamental for us to grow. So we are looking into it, and we'll see what happens. Time will tell.
All right, Sunil, stay with us. We'll take a quick break and we'll come back to find out more about Sunil as a person, not just as a chief executive and managing director. Stay tuned. You're watching View on the Top. Sunil, people who have interacted with you say that you don't mince any words. You say it as it is. You're a hard taskmaster. And of course, a hard negotiator, which all of us know after the Ranbaxy Daichi deal. All of it is true?
None of it is true. I'm a very soft, kind-hearted person. I don't believe where you're getting all the information from, you know. And when you're driving a business, mm-hmm. you need to have an agenda. There has to be, every business has to have an anchor. And the anchor can be money or anchor can be a relationship. I think Religare is always focused on having relationship as an anchor and money not being the driving factor. Mm-hmm. But that leads to other set of challenges. You need to focus the people, you need to channelize the people into understanding, listen, it's important that, you know, everything is there, but we need to deliver. There are shareholder expectations, there are expectations within themselves of the people. Eventually everybody has to grow, the organization needs to grow. So do that, you have to take certain calls. I think you evolve as a personality, really don't time it. But as a person, I think I'm very kind. I don't think I'm a hard taskmaster. We just sort of put together what we really want to do, and we go around doing it in a very straight, meaningful manner. That's about it. And you know, you state things which are facts. Fact is a fact. You just put it across.
Leading this business, what have been the challenges, and what do you think really carried you forward successfully?
I think the only challenge we had in the beginning was having the people accept themselves that they have a capacity to do it. We all have a latent capacity to do it and deliver what we want to do. The challenge is understanding that. So I mean, we all knew that we wanted to go somewhere, and there was a market there, there was a roadmap there, and we would do it. But I think the challenge is making the people believe in themselves. And once they have tasted that belief, they've tasted blood, sort of, yes, we can do it, it's not a challenge anymore. Then they're all doing it. So I think challenge is putting a team together, putting systems together, which we did, and that's what is carrying us today. And I don't see any further challenges going ahead. I think it's just the road that we need to continue doing and getting it and getting better at it, you know.
So what's the vision of you and your team together?
Well, the vision is, we all align, is to put Religare as the most trusted global financial services brand. We like to say it's a globally trusted financial services brand. Mm-hmm. Something that people, the moment they talk Religare, it signifies trust. It leads to people think, yeah, this is a brand that we can believe in. And this is again delivered by the people that stand behind the brand. So how we behave, how we talk, we always say we live Religare. It's not a company you work in, you live it every day. So you need to believe in that. You need to have the passion, the courage to really accept it and do that, you know.
And what are the passions outside of work? What is Sunil Godhwani outside of work?
You see, when you're working in Religare, you have no outside of work. Everything is within the company.
I'm glad you're being honest about it.
There is none. I mean, you know, it's a way of life. You cannot be a personality that turns off and turns on. I mean, what you are at home, you've got to be at work, you know. You can't say, okay, I'm like this outside, when I come into office, I'm like that. As I said, it's a way of life, it's a culture that we believe in. So outside work also, it is something that we are continuing in, when we are in office, of course, all Religare. When you're outside, we're looking for opportunities for Religare. Mm-hmm. So outside Religare, Sunil Godhwani is nobody, is just a simple, ordinary person. Everything is there because of Religare.
So you're saying 16 hours, 18 hours of work is normal?
I don't think it's normal, but like to do it if there's, you know, I don't think it's normal in any sense.
All right, I just worry and wonder what your CEOs will say after this, or they probably already know this.
No, I mean to say, if you tell them 16 hours, they say, why not 24?